Greetings. I recently received some really good questions from someone in Islam. This precious brother has been sincere and respectful and very civil. Allow me to share his honest questions and my answers with you so that you too may be edified. Why don't all Christians recognize Jehovah as God's name? And if this is a Greek word, is God a Greek God? I've already had this discussion with you that Bible is also a Greek word. It comes from Biblos, so the Bible is Greek. If Jesus send, I think he means was sent, to the children of Israel, why is it in Greek then? Can you answer this question for me? Like I said, these are some really good questions. So I replied with the following. First, let me give you some background information. The Bible documents two covenants by God. These are the Old Covenant, documented in the Old Testament, and the New Covenant, documented in the New Testament. The Old Testament was recorded in Hebrew, my friend, and the New Testament was recorded in Greek, and there is a very specific reason for this. The promise God made to Abraham was that by Abraham all nations would be blessed. So the New Covenant, which is the fulfillment of this promise, was recorded in the language that was widely in use at the time. Greek. I did not include the following information in my response, but it is the scriptural support for my statements. You'll recognize it by this new background pattern of clouds. Genesis 18:18. Seeing that Abraham shall surely become a great and mighty nation, and all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him. Galatians 3:8. And the scripture, foreseeing that God would justify the heathen through faith, preached before the gospel unto Abraham, saying, In thee shall all nations be blessed. So here is the New Testament referring back to God's foreseeing in the Old Testament, how God preached the gospel unto Abraham. So this is again my response. Jesus himself was specifically sent to the Jewish people, to Israel, because he was the prophet foretold by prophet Moses in Deuteronomy 18. But his message, the gospel, or good news, which is called the Injil in Arabic, was about salvation for all mankind, who would believe him and receive the gift that he offered. So that is why the New Testament is in Greek and the Old Testament is in Hebrew. Now I'll answer your specific questions, my friend. He asks, why don't all Christians recognize Jehovah as God's name? That is a failure to educate believers. It is also a problem with the Roman Catholic religion, which tried to control Christianity for many hundreds of years. They tried to keep the knowledge of the Bible only within the priesthood. But their selfishness actually resulted in the Word of God being completely preserved. They kept manuscript evidence protected and safe so that other religions coming after Christianity could not destroy the Word of God. He asked, and if this is a Greek word, is God a Greek God? Yah is not a Greek word, it is Hebrew, and God is the God of all mankind, my friend. God has both the ability and the right to decide how he interacts with humanity. He is God. If Jesus was sent to the children of Israel, why is it in Greek then? Can you answer this question for me? Hopefully, given the above answers, this question becomes more clear. Jesus was sent to the house of Israel. He was the prophet spoken of in Deuteronomy 18. While he was on the earth, he obviously spoke the languages of the region, definitely Hebrew. He read from the Hebrew scriptures at synagogue when he was a young man. So Jesus spoke Hebrew without question. Deuteronomy 18:15. The Lord thy God will raise up unto thee a prophet from the midst of thee, of thy brethren like unto me, unto him shall you hearken. This is the prophecy that God gave in Deuteronomy 18, speaking of the prophet he would raise up unto thee, meaning unto Israel. Deuteronomy 18:18, I will raise them up, meaning raise up unto Israel, a prophet from among their brethren, like unto thee, and will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him. Matthew 15:24, but he, meaning Jesus, answered and said, I am not sent but unto the lost sheep of the house of Israel. So Jesus in his earthly ministry was only sent to Israel. John 5:46, for had you believed Moses, you would have believed me, for he wrote of me. This is one of the most clear scriptures Jesus spoke about when he said, Moses wrote of me. So Jesus clearly knew that Moses wrote about Jesus when he was talking in Deuteronomy 18 of the prophet who would come. Luke 24:25. Then he said unto them, O fools and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken, ought not Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory? And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he, meaning Jesus, expounded unto them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. So Jesus taught all about the references all throughout the Old Testament, through Moses, through the prophets. He taught his disciples what all of the references and mentions were. So this is more of my response. The Apostle Paul, who Jesus personally called into ministry, was an educated man. He spoke Hebrew and Greek and possibly other languages, since Paul was also a Roman citizen and spoke with the Romans during his life and ministry. When God inspired Paul to record the revelations which he had received personally from Jesus, Paul wrote them in Greek. Since Paul was called by Jesus to spread the gospel, the good news or the Injil, to the Gentile world. If Paul only wrote in Hebrew, then only Hebrew speakers and readers could understand it. So God chose someone capable of spreading and sharing the good news, the Injil, with those who were not Hebrew and did not speak or read Hebrew. And that was the extent of my message response to this precious brother. Like I said, these are some really good questions. If you call yourself Muslim, why don't you believe Moses? Moses wrote about Jesus. Jesus said, Moses wrote about me. In John 5:46, Jesus said, for had you believed Moses, you would have believed me, for he wrote of me. But if you believe not his writings, how shall you believe my words? If you believed Moses' writings, you would believe Jesus' words, my friend. Why are you told to say you believe Moses than taught to reject his writings. Think about that. Ask yourself, why are you told to say you believe Moses? In Surah 2, 136, you are taught there is no distinction between what Moses brought and the Quran. There is no distinction between the Torah and the Quran. So why then do you reject the Torah? Pray for this precious brother and for all in Islam who sincerely want to respect God, Moses, and Jesus. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who Moses wrote about. Amen.